report that we have zero new cases. So that's excellent news. And we have had 5,718 tests in the past 24 hours. And 14,920 vaccines were done by Queensland Health yesterday. Now, how good was Bunnings? I mean, that was absolutely fantastic. So well done for everyone who came out. In total, there were 7,922 people got their vaccine. And I want to see, hopefully, more Bunnings this weekend, because obviously people are more than happy to come and get their vaccines there. So as of today, we have 72.26% of Queenslanders have at least one dose, and 56.58 are now fully vaccinated. So can I just say that Cabinet has had a very good meeting today, and we want to update Queensland about a few issues that I think we'll see the possibility of families being able to reunite in time for Christmas. Now, it's going to be really important that Queenslanders do one thing, and that is to get vaccinated. I cannot stress the imperative to getting vaccinated, because there is going to be a risk of Delta outbreaks happening in Queensland, and we need to be prepared. I can say that in Brisbane, the vaccination rates are much higher than in regional Queensland, and we are one state. So we need the vaccination rates to increase right across the state. To that end, I'll be sending my ministers out to the length and breadth of Queensland this week, urging those people who are not vaccinated to get vaccinated. We're all in this together. If we're going to weather this storm, think about it in terms of how we deal with natural disasters. We're going to weather this storm. We can be so prepared for this storm if we get vaccinated now. So I'm urging Queenslanders, this is your last opportunity. This is your last chance to get vaccinated. Minister Grace is going to be looking at how we can get the vaccines into schools during school hours so people, the kids, can get vaccinated, that 12 to 15-year-old age group. We're looking at Bunnings, but it is absolutely imperative that people get vaccinated. We have always had a measured and cautious approach, and Queenslanders have done such a great job. I think, you know, we're the envy of not just other parts of Australia, but I think, you know, in other parts of the world. People were shocked when I was over in Tokyo being able to tell them that we have been able to weather the Delta storm. But we know that the world is a big place, and there are families across Australia, and there are families across the world. And people have been telling me how they miss seeing their uncles, their aunts, their mothers, their fathers, their children. This is really important that we unite Queenslanders, but we do it in the safest way. So we are going to try and minimise the risk. And there's a couple of key steps that we'll take along this path. And don't forget too, because we've had that strong health response, our economy has been booming, and the Treasurer will talk a little bit about that. And we want to see that continue into the future. So my job as Premier is to keep Queenslanders safe. And the way I can help protect you is for you now to go and protect yourself by getting vaccinated. It is absolutely critical. So what does that mean? Well, today I'm releasing our Queensland's COVID vaccine plan. It's a measured and cautious plan that will do what we want to do, reunite families and protect Queensland from Delta. It sets out dates when we expect to achieve 70 and 80% of eligible Queenslanders who are fully vaccinated. And if we keep getting vaccinated, we'll be able to welcome family and friends from interstate hotspots in a little over a month who are fully vaccinated. And a month after that, in December, they'll be able to come without having to quarantine in time for Christmas, but they too will need to be fully vaccinated. And I think Queenslanders would acknowledge that that is a sensible and cautious approach to ensure that families can be reunited, but the people coming into Queensland will have to be fully vaccinated. So the faster we are vaccinated, the faster these deadlines will be achieved. So it does mean that some of these dates may come forward if we get the vaccination rates up. So if we reach 70% sooner than November 19, we will ease the restrictions sooner. And if you are fully vaccinated, you are 86% less likely to catch COVID and pass it on. And Dr. Young will talk a little bit more about that. So I'll just run through it. So at 70% of Queensland's eligible population fully vaccinated is expected on November the 19th. So if you are coming from a declared domestic hotspot, so that's like New South Wales or Victoria, in the previous 14 days, you can travel into Queensland provided that you are fully vaccinated and you arrive by air and have a negative COVID test in the previous 72 hours, and you'll have to undertake home quarantine for 14 days. Now that changes because it's going to be a lot safer for Queenslanders when we are 80% fully vaccinated, and that fits in with the national plan as well. And we've done modelling to look at all of this as well, so Yvette will speak to a little bit about that modelling. But at 80% of Queensland's eligible population fully vaccinated expected on December 17, travellers from an interstate hotspot can arrive by road or by air. They must be fully vaccinated. They must have a negative COVID test in the previous 72 hours, and no quarantine will be required. So that is good news for families to be reunited for Christmas. And of course, that December 17 may come sooner if we reach those thresholds sooner. So it's up to Queenslanders. It's definitely up to Queenslanders. So some very good news today, and I'll hand over to the Deputy Premier to say a few words, and then you'll hear from the Chief Health Officer, the Health Minister, and the Treasurer, and then we're happy to take some questions.
Well, today the Premier is doing exactly what Queenslanders have learned to expect from her, as she has always done throughout this entire pandemic. She's outlining to Queenslanders a measured, cautious and safe approach, one that is informed by the best health advice, one that puts the safety and health of Queenslanders and our economic interests first. It is based on the best advice and the best available modelling. It is not a series of reckless decisions as we've seen from New South Wales. We will not give up on having a plan as the Prime Minister has. Queenslanders, we can do this and we can do it with a plan. When the vaccine arrived, we said it was the beginning of the end, and this is a plan to finish vaccinating Queenslanders, a plan to bring families back together, a plan to get us moving around again and start welcoming people to our state again. It's also a plan that begins to set a deadline for Queenslanders to get vaccinated before we expect COVID to start arriving here, the 17th of December. There have already been lots of good reasons to get vaccinated. So you don't get the virus, so you don't get as sick, or you're less likely to get the virus, less likely to get sick, less likely to pass it on to somebody that you love. But this plan gives you even more reasons to get vaccinated. If you want to move around more, travel around more after the 17th of December, get vaccinated now. If you want your family to visit for Christmas, get vaccinated now. If you want to avoid regionalised lockdowns and restrictions, get vaccinated now. And that's particularly important in those regions where their vaccination rate has been lagging. We're also saying that after that 17th of December, when we expect to meet the 80% of the eligible population double vaccinated, there will be other freedoms that are only available to people who've been vaccinated. We will work with industry and business, but we expect that there will be some settings and venues that decide to be vaccinated only. And in return, they will have eased restrictions. So there are venues that you can go to now if you're unvaccinated that you won't be able to go to after the 17th of December. And if you want to continue to go to those venues and businesses that may choose to be vaccinated only, then get vaccinated now. And finally, if you want it to be sooner than the 17th of December, get vaccinated now. And if we meet those targets sooner, we'll be able to bring forward those timeframes.
Thank you, Premier. So, no new cases in Queensland overnight, which is fantastic, and we do not have any active clusters today in Queensland. So the most important thing now is we have a time frame to aim for, the 17th of December, which means the latest people can get vaccinated and be protected is 6 weeks before then, and we might even get there earlier. And the most important thing every single Queenslander 12 years of age or older needs to do is protect themselves, because once we start seeing cases, this virus will find people who aren't vaccinated. We know that you are very protected if you're vaccinated. So we now have a deadline. That's the 17th of December. Hopefully it'll happen even earlier than that, because I know people want to get out and about. And now I make a plea to younger people. If younger people were to get vaccinated, we would reach that target even earlier. It's younger people in that 20 to 39 year age group who probably feel they're invincible, but you're not. You need to get vaccinated so we can return to a normal way of life.